Welcome everybody back here for another week of Talk Dota. You thought we're going to have a week off, and then we said, you know what, we don't care how much has been drunk, we don't care what the hell happened this weekend, actually we care about that, it's the reason why we do this kind of show, but we said, you know what, the show must go on, so this Tuesday night, we are back at 22 CST as always. syndereN will not be here, but luckily you do still have myself, TobiWan Kenobi, as well as Puppey, going to be talking about everything that is Dota 2. We start off as always with our weekly wrap-up, which is talking about everything that happened in the week. We'll then go ourselves into what was normally a special guest time, but we're going to our community section as well as catch up and see just how badly I was wrong with my predictions last weekend. That'll be coming up in our second segment. And the third segment, for people who don't know, there was a patch log that came out recently for Dota, and we are going to be decoding that with Melk coming out from EG. We will also have Painted Gold from Quantix. Again, the Americans have their words to come in, and maybe even going to pull in a Swede if he turns up in time. Wagamama are going to come and join us. But anyway, Puppey, firstly, welcome and congratulations for your win this weekend.
Thanks, thank you, thanks. They're saying syndereN is like out of sync. You better fix that.
Yeah, I'll definitely work on syndereN, man. Like, his voice is so wrong for it.
And his video isn't really moving, so his webcam.
They're probably also talking about me. There is a small glitch with my camera, by the way, guys, which is making a small delay of maybe half a second. Hopefully it's not too crazy for you guys, and it might settle down as we go through it all. But let's actually start it, man, because the way we do the weekly catch-up, we like to go fast, we like to go quick, and we can talk about a big point I want to start with, which is China finally getting Dota 2. Now, this was something which I know has always been an issue, getting games into China, censorship in China, and basically to have a game released in China, you must have a Chinese distributor backing your game, or else the game will not go anywhere. But it goes to a developer called Perfect World. I am assuming you've never heard of them before.
Never heard of them before.
But yeah, Perfect World basically saying, you know what, we'll bring Dota 2 to China, which for me is amazing, because this is really the first concrete evidence we've had out there saying that Dota 2 will come to the public in China, and that's something which we haven't really seen, man. Like, we've seen it in tournaments, we've seen it in other little areas, but as far as the public in China getting Dota 2, this is the first thing we have ever seen come out from there. I'm interested to see how it's going to change, because we kind of know the Chinese scene is strong when they focus, but kind of what happens when the rest of China picks it up and now everybody in all of China starts playing Dota 2?
But what do they do? Can you explain it to me? Because I'm not really sure what is this Perfect World?
Perfect World. I tried to look up about them, and it looks like they sell games as far as for China. That's it. It's a raw distributor.
Okay.
So it's just mean the game can get into the country. I don't know if that then means that it'll be like the whole Garena kind of thing, where Garena is then separated from the rest of, like, what they do with Heroes of New Earth, where it's separated and the stats are separated, if Steam is not going to be used in China.
Yeah, that might be it. But Steam is pretty universal. I don't think there would be a problem with it. But please call it Garena, not Garena.
I could call it what the Australians used to call it, but that is rather inappropriate.
Does it start with N?
It's not that inappropriate. It's not that inappropriate.
Not that inappropriate, so. All right.
Let's move on to what happened this weekend, which was StarLadder. For people who don't know, this weekend in Kiev at Cyber Arena, there were 7 teams competing for the StarLadder men's final. There was also a women's tournament happening on the side of it too, which had owned by. Played up against Virtus Pro Ladies. That also happened this weekend. We had OB being the winner of the female tournament, as well as Na'Vi. Damn you, Puppey. You screwed us both over on our TalkDOTA predictions. You ended up winning up against Empire 3-1, the final, with a one-game advantage. So it was basically 2-1 on the main stage. That was happening this weekend. Of course, we had some nice statistics come out from this as well. For those guys that don't know, there was over 100,000 people viewing as a peak. This was across the Chinese live stream. Of course, They love their Dota as well, but we had about 63,000 at peak on the English and Russian streams combined together. And then there was another 40,000 which came through the Chinese live stream. There's also 2K or 3K coming through on the Spanish live stream. If you haven't checked out those guys, you definitely check out Antenna Dota. Those guys are kind of nuts when they cast. I finally watched a VOD of theirs. I finally watched a VOD of theirs last night, and it's actually quite hilarious. There's also the French live stream and a couple of other things coming out. But, Puppy, as far as Starladder went this weekend, we were kind of all wrong. Like, Moscow 5, like the first three teams got eliminated. MYM, which was a little bit predictable. Everyone hopes everyone does well, but yeah. Yeah, so MYM were knocked out. Moscow 5 and Virtus Pro were removed pretty early. Like, as far as the groups go, I think you probably agree with me, man. Virtus Pro had it a little bit tough. Virtus Pro had it tough.
They were... Well, for them, it was the group of death, so...
Yeah.
I mean, and they were the only ones in the group of death, because the group of death consists of the two mega teams that were in this tournament, so they were the last one. It's still weird. No, it's actually fine. I'm not sure. Like, the way that this tournament went through is that they chose what teams will be in their group, and that will call unbalanced. It will just bias everything over, just because Empire doesn't want to face against us in the group stage. I mean, not in the group stage. They don't want to face us in the brackets. So they choose us, so it just instantly becomes a randomly made group of death, like in the tournament where you have all the Chinese teams in one group. And if the Chinese are like, well, we don't, like, if there would be one Chinese team that could choose everybody into their group and they think they are the strongest, they would definitely choose all of the Chinese teams so they could beat everybody else later in the brackets. It will totally bias this whole tournament off. So I don't really agree how this tournament was made, but well, seven teams came up also.
Four. Yeah, if it was meant to be all of the teams, EG who didn't turn up, and obviously they said they couldn't make it in the end. And you can only fill in so many teams from Europe. So hey, maybe next Star Ladder, like it's not far away. Like the finals for the next one meant to be set in December. So it is really, there's hopefully a lot more teams that we won't have this horrible instability we had beforehand, and then, like, you know what, we can turn up. But then again, we had some amazing teams turn up. Like, as far as quality teams go, I was really happy with all the games we had, like Skorne, Pulse. They played amazing Dota. We had the good B team who played Dota out of what anybody was expecting them to play. Like, they brought us some really good games. Then Empire, rough during the group stages, but got themselves through. And then they played really amazing Dota on day three, like when they knocked out Skorne as well as the good B team. It was pretty one-sided, both those games, because Empire was just, they managed to find a league of their own on that day. And they kind of play very similar Dota in the first game up against you guys, but obviously we know not everything was going 100% right for you guys in that first game. Yeah,
but it's weird that GD, I thought they figured Empire out, because it's not like I have figured them out. I have. Whatever. Anyway, I won them, so everything's cool. The fact is that I asked Kuro, did he figure out what they actually do, or do you, like, understand that you cannot counter what they do? They just have a playstyle of, like, these undyings that just go into your hard lane and you can't kill them. If you try to counter it, you will die. Like, he will try to counter it with a Weaver. Yes, this Weaver will massage him on his lane, but he won't do anything. Just a good massage, you know, it's not bad, but you won't do anything. You won't win the game through that.
So that's stuff. That's why Wagamama is the king of offlane, because he's just so good at massaging a hero. If people don't know, Wagamama is actually a masseuse. He's actually really good as well. I think he helped out a couple of players at Starladder.
He helps them all with happy endings, you know, especially Toby.
I didn't have a happy ending from him, but I did get a very good laugh when we found him in the airport with vomit all the way down his leg. For people who didn't know, that was who the picture of a leg on my Twitter was. It was, in fact, Wagamama. Let's go into something else, man. G1 League, they are different things. G1 League has actually started already. There's been a lot of games coming out from this one. If you want to check out the live stream, always look for Beyond the Summit, God's live stream for that one. And we can check out right now. As far as the groups are going, would you believe it when we tell you that Group A is being dominated by IG as well as LGD?
No, I wouldn't believe it.
That's crazy, man. That's crazy. EG hasn't played any of their games yet, but Sequential Gaming, who really have been playing really... like, they're a really up-and-coming team coming out from Australia. Like, not 100% yet at the level of Natural 9, but as far as, like, skill, talent, kind of, like, developed to work together as 5 goes. But they've been doing pretty well in other competitions, but both Sequential Gaming and MUFC dropping down at 0-2. But Natural 9 is, in fact, there's a 4-way tie in Group B. Natural 9, Orange, Tongfu, DK. All played 2 games, all 1-1, lost 1. Everybody is just balanced in that group, and Flash from Singapore hasn't played anything yet.
Well, Orange, Tongfu, and DK are really good teams. I think Orange Sports is much stronger than EG, Sequential, and MUFC.
We also take into effect that EG plays with a 350 ping on Melk and... all that kind of jazz. They're playing Singapore.
It's their problem. They came into this tournament, so I could play this tournament also. It doesn't mean like I'm going to play without. If I'm going to play on a European host, shit, not. But Orange is missing Mushi right now.
Mm-hmm.
So that isn't that strong as I thought. But still, Orange is Orange. They have their 3 real type of like support players, and it will still go far. And yeah, Mate.
Yeah. Well, maybe when Mushi gets back, that might start changing around for Orange. I'm pretty sure if they get themselves into the playoffs, Mushi will come off his holiday break and come back to the world of Dota. Someone who is coming back to the world of Dota but is also changing around, this is something which is happening with Experience Gaming. We kind of have forgotten that name, but it's on its way back right now. But it's in Hon. So it's Loda, Aki, Nose, Spader X, and Nikwa, and
Spader X. You don't know who Spader X is, right?
No, I don't know who Spader X is. Who is Spader X?
Yeah, I won't even tell you.
Great, fantastic. People have talked that it will not be enlightened either. Nikwa and Strangby are their team. So that's who's playing in the Heroes of New Earth team. But it's also a bit of a contradiction because they're playing in the Hon Tour, which was the new thing which was all announced recently. But Loda also tweeted out the fact that he is going to announce his Dota 2 team soon. So it appears we have ourselves another Fnatic EU where they want to play both at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, guys, Fnatic NA has also picked up a new team. If you haven't checked it out, check out joindota.com for the news. We're not going to go into it much apart from the fact that it doesn't involve PowerNet, which was... funny, that team never got off the ground. And MTW as well. MTW, the guy who's dodging us now is also dodging 4PL. They were signed up to compete in the 4PL tournament with a set roster. And there were some hints to the new roster of MTW that will be heading to DreamHack. But we're left waiting yet maybe another week or so before we'll get to know the MTW roster. It's just sitting there right now with no announcements whatsoever. We would ask Synd, but obviously he ain't here.
Yeah, he ain't here. Mushi plays for Orange, by the way. Mr. Toby, Mr. News Guy, Mr. Streamer, who should know every player and stuff. I didn't know. I thought he retired for a little while, but I guess he's like HYHY. I was like, yeah,
no,
whatever.
He didn't retire. I believe he just
took a break. Okay.
He went on holidays for 2 months, and I thought he was still on holidays. Is he actually playing now for G1? I unfortunately haven't had time to check all the games or any of the games.
Any of the games either, right here.
Yeah, it's because we've been busy. We were in Kiev.
Hey, you want to guess who's Spader X? I'll give you hints.
I'm looking forward to the hint.
All right. He's Swedish.
He's Swedish?
Yes.
That doesn't limit it down much, man. There's a
No. you just, you know, you say some names and then you say too much, even if the name is right, I can give you another hint, you know. I'll give you three hints.
I love how people are guessing Loader, but Loader is the captain of the team. People saying it's Miracle. Where's Lacoste?
Lacoste is not...
Actually, no, Lacoste Swedish. Isn't Swedish, isn't he? He just played with... he plays with CLG, and I'm like, oh.
Anyway, it is Miracle. You're right.
Well, so why would he put himself a Spade Erect?
Because we all had shitty names when we were playing in Han. My name was Wysak.
Really? How long were you playing in Han? Like, what tour did you play in?
I don't remember. I really don't. I played for 2 weeks. Yeah, 2 weeks. And I just played SF and SF and SF and SF.
That was it.
But I remember that my clockwork destroyed the team named EG that time. Oh, man. Every other team had to ban it then. So
smooth.
I mean, Pharaoh. Not clockwork. Pharaoh.
Yeah. Oh, man. The mummy wall. The tormented soul. Let's go on to our last point right now for as far as the weekly wrap-up goes, which is of interesting note. Red Bull recently announced that they are looking to get themselves into esports and that they're wanting to really start to back it up because Red Bull, I don't know if you guys saw the man jumping from space, but Red Bull was pumping a crap ton of money into all of that. That was a thing streamed out on YouTube. But yeah, Red Bull have announced the fact that Dota 2 is definitely in their sights. They've got a couple of other things like Tekken Tag tournaments, Halo 4, Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Sad about that one. But Dota 2 was at the top of their list, top of their article, which is absolutely fantastic. And I know for people like myself who are always looking to see if sponsors are going to get involved in tournaments, having a big brand like Red Bull really start to back a game like Dota 2, it's... For us, it's massively exciting to see something like that. It's like having Red Bull and then Coke saying, you know what? Yeah, we'll sponsor Na'Vi now.
Please do.
Then you can start spending your money on all this Coke and...
No, I can spend my money on buying joinDOTA and making, like, Toby wear a skirt every day to work. That's totally what I'm going to do.
So the Lord of Estonia is going to buy out joinDOTA with the money he won from the International 2.
No, from sponsoring Coke.
Oh, okay.
The real Coke, you know? Anyway, start wearing a skirt already. Get up to it because I'm going to get sponsored. And you're probably going to have to do it, so get used to it.
I've worn a kilt before. It's fine. Not wearing a real skirt that like killed is fine. But my own Scottish heritage. I'm happy to.
I thought you said I've killed before.
No, a kilt, you know, like a Scottish.
I know.
Yeah. There's even in fact old pictures of me. You can find it with me in a kilt. If you can find it, then I'm gonna murder you.
Yeah, because he's killed before with a kilt.
There's actually in a public place if people can find it, but luckily you can't use my real name to find it. It's very, very difficult to find, which is a very, very upside. Another upside is we're going to end this opening segment, so the weekly wrap-up is now over. That's all we said. Let's do it nice, quick, and short so we don't have to bore you with all the other roster changes and everything else happening. So we'll be back here. We're going to bring on the 12th Doctor to have a talk about how badly we all did in predictions last week, and to also talk about questions from the community. So if you've asked your question in the thread, I've managed to pull out a couple of them, which I think is going to give us some decent conversation between myself and Puppey, and we'll be back here to answer that number two. Third section, which will be coming up in probably about half an hour's time, will be when we are joined by our expert panel, which will be consisting of Malk from Evil Geniuses, Quantic Painted Gold, or is it still Quantic? No, they... Yes. It's Painted Gold joining us. And maybe Scorne Wagamama might be joining us as well. So stick around. We'll be back here with more
Pulse. Talk.
Pulse! It's so natural now to say Scorne.
I know. I say Scorne. Like, you learned the word Scorne for like 3 months, and now they say you can't use it anymore. Learned it, but can't use it.
Yeah. It's Pulse now. It's Pulse. I should think it should be the Pulse of Scorne. Should be the new name of the team. Anyway, we'll be back. TalkDOTA, Section 2, coming up soon.